it's always interesting, isn't it? If you go to an organization or you go to an individual and you say, okay, what's taking the time? If you go to an organization, you know, commonly if you ask about reporting, all right, so every month, what reporting do you do? How do you aggregate that information? Oh, well, I send this email with this spreadsheet and then I get all of these back and then I have to collate them and then I have to put them over in this system over here and then I magically create something by hand every time. Okay, that's about 4 days a month, you know, and you kind of go, okay, that's 4 days a month that somebody's spending doing that. There's an opportunity there. And then you look at individuals and you're kind of going, so if you spend a minute a day doing that, but you do it every single day, if you get it down to a second, how much time you save in a year? It's like a day. It's like, whoa, okay, wait a second, that might be worth investing in. You know, and it's always that equation of, you know, how much time are you going to spend when you aggregate it all up? How much effort you're going to put in actually automating something or making it better or just doing the research to find out what that keystroke is?
Yeah.
And then you've got, okay, I can save myself 5 days a year just by spending an hour doing a little bit of binging to find the right keystroke.
Yeah.
And it's always an interesting conversation when you talk about it that way with clients.
It is interesting. I think a lot of people tend to go directly or indirectly down automation route first. So if you ask them what takes the time, like reporting's a pain. As a quick aside, you know, being a reformed accountant, it still amazes me that, you know, when I started work, people used to close the books in 3 days after the month end and then like another 2 weeks doing reporting. And it seems like that has not changed in like 10, 20 years. Like, why does it take, we've got computers. Yeah. Why is it 3 days to know what you've just done in the previous month? Should it be like, right, the month's over. All right, cool. It's done. If anything, one click to finish it, one click to run the reports, done. And then everyone's just got access to everything. So I don't know why that's not improved. But anyway, people directly or indirectly sort of get down automation. And then when you're trying to like speed up, even just speed up reports or speed up the way that they're doing stuff or jump into Power Automate to do something whizzy, people like, you know, normal end users sort of start to get freaked out because they think that the company's trying to remove my job, which is like the opposite of what I want to be known for. I want to empower people to have better lives at work, make more sales, have better well-being. You know, if a company's interested in getting rid of half their staff, then we're not a good fit to work together.
I'm Gavin Jones, founder and director at MeeTime, where we help people save time at work using Microsoft 365 and Microsoft Teams. If you need help saving time at work, I've got a free course linked in the description below that you can get some tips and tricks on how to use Microsoft Teams, Microsoft To Do, Microsoft Planner, and make yourself more productive at work. If you're struggling to get your whole organization to change, we've got another free course that might be useful to help generate some ideas that you might be able to steal to make your whole organization work in a more modern way.
That's why, like now, 80%, I say, of people's actual time wasted, even if they say it's reporting, is actually emails and meetings still.
Oh, yeah.
And yeah. I think one of the best kept secrets that Microsoft very rarely talk about is Viva Insights and the workplace analytics bit of Viva Insights after they now rebranded it into one license. Because that's just the amount of data you can get on how people work together in the organization with a paid bit of Viva Insights. It's so cheap. I don't know why everyone doesn't have it. It's absolutely amazing to then just show back to senior management that we're spending 20 hours a week on emails and meetings in the sales force, and only 1 hour of that is external. 19 hours are internal stuff. Why are we tying up our sales force with internal stuff like that? And that's not including the stuff that's outside of Microsoft, like, you know, people putting stuff into their forecasting system, phone calls with the customer if you haven't got, you know, it's not routed through Teams. And there's just so much opportunity to streamline all of that work first, and then doing that ahead of automation, one also makes people feel that you're, you know, you've got their best interests at heart because they hate emails and meetings, and you're helping remove that from their burden.
love meetings. They love a good invite that's going to take them, you know, an hour out of their day with no information about what's expected or, you know, what you're going to do in that meeting. Everybody loves that, don't they?
Who needs an agenda, right? It just gets in the way. It just spoils the fun.
People must love them because they accept every single one. Like, can stick an hour in with any senior level and they'll accept it. Very nice place to work, I should say. But you could stick an hour in with anybody in the company and they would accept it. No agenda. And it's fine. But that's also then causing a lot of anxiety, angst, because you just couldn't have got no time in the day to do anything because there's so many meetings. And I think that's very usual for a large company these days.
Before you go, if you like this video, remember to give it a thumbs up. It really does help us in the algorithm. We've got super thanks turned on now. So if you really liked it, then consider supporting the channel with a donation. Thanks for watching so far, and we'll see you in the next video.